Welcome back, and thank you so much for staying with NTV Weekend Edition tonight. We will dive into Talk of the Nation, and today we do look at officials in Luwero District that are concerned about population figures showing a surge in the uptake of contraceptives among teenagers. According to the Luwero District Health Report, at least 78,442 teenagers sought contraceptives in the district in the financial year 2020-2021. The situation is replicated in several other districts of the country, and we do wonder tonight, should we be worried? We have JOHNSON KIIZA of Public Health Ambassadors Uganda. A very good evening, and thank you so much for joining us tonight on Talk of the Nation.
Thank you so much for hosting me. I'm happy to be here, and a good evening to you.
Well, we are coming to a week after World Contraception Day, and if we are to look at the sub-theme, contraception, it is your life, your responsibility. This report, should it worry us as a country? Is it something that we should concern ourselves with?
If it's in relation to the fact that the access and utilization of contraceptives for young people is increasing, I think it's a good thing, because the real worry is the challenges that are coming out of issues of the early sex debut that is happening among young people. And these are coming through they're being contributed by different factors. One of them are early marriages, because child marriages are still existing. The statistics are still worrying, but also the statistics of early sex debut, most especially for rural areas, but even urban areas, are still worrying. Statistics show that 25% of adolescents get pregnant by the age of 18. So it means that it can't be a hidden fact that young people are engaging into sexual relations. And of course, if you look at the challenges that the pandemic has brought, the pandemic has made young people stay home the longest ever. So the opportunities of different relations that resulted to sexual relations are many. So I think that the government plus implementing partners who are increasing access for contraceptive use for young people, they have done a good job. Of course, the gap is still there. So when you look at a report where the utilization is increasing, it shouldn't be a worry. It should be a good thing. In fact, this is something that the public has to embrace, because the fact is the teenage mothers in terms of numbers are very high. The unwanted pregnancies, the numbers are very high, they are very worrying. This is affecting the GDP of the nation. It is affecting very many factors. It is affecting a lot of dropouts in school and things like that. So I think we should embrace the results from that report, and we should actually be working more to increasing access for contraceptives for young people.
Now, as a Public Health Ambassadors Uganda, really we should be talking about maybe abstinence, but as preaching the gospel of contraceptives, would you say it is encouraging young people to get sexually active because they have some bit of protection somewhere?
I think abstinence is still valid, but I would say it is still, we should apply it as one of the ways to fight early unwanted and unplanned pregnancies. But it's not the only way, because like I told you, there are very many cultures that are still practicing child marriages. In fact, studies show that 34% of women between the age of 24 to 49 were married before their 18th birthday, and they continue giving birth throughout the age of 40. So imagine what it contributes to the fertility rate of the nation. So if child marriages are still existing, if young people are engaging in early sex relations, then you have to be worried if you are fronting only abstinence as the solution. So that's why the government and implementing partners are doing so much to avail and increase access and for contraceptives, or access to contraceptives for young people, because it is the fact on the table that young people are engaging in sex relations. So it is important for them to have the information in terms of sex education, how to protect yourself, to be equipped. In fact, the FP 2030 commitment, which is like a global commitment for all countries where Uganda is also signatory, it has a vision that by 2030, every girl and every woman should have an opportunity to live a health life where they can make a decision on how many children they should have and when they should have them. So when you give them every tool they need and every information they need to make that decision, that is you contributing to the or for them to live a health life. So I do think abstinence, it is still one, but it can't be the only solution. And the drive to increase access to contraceptives is very valid, and we should all be embracing it and contributing to it.
Well, in the past, we did see that talk of contraceptives among teenagers was really unheard of. Would you say that now it has been fully embraced by, say, the children, the teenagers, I would say teenagers actually, and the parents themselves? And how can we continue to embrace the whole aspect of contraceptives for the benefit of our young people, but also our day-to-day decisions?
I think in terms of embracing the utilization of contraceptives, yes, halfway it has been embraced. I still think there are gaps. One of the gaps I want to keenly mention is the contribution of parents. You see, parents are the first hand contact in terms of providing information in relation to sex education. And like I mentioned, the COVID-19 has given parents an unplanned opportunity to stay with their children for a very long time.
True.
So now, if you're a parent and you look at numbers or statistics of teenage pregnancies, doesn't it worry you? You may look at these numbers because they are nationally surveyed, originally surveyed. But in reality, these are numbers that are very close to your home. Soon or later, your house will be a statistic of a teenage mother. So as a parent, you have to support the government and be involved by providing information to your child, to sit down with your child and start having conversation about sex education. That is the, in fact, that is the first line of prevention. And then as a parent, you need to know about these contraceptives, how they work, because then it is better that your child learns them from you instead of learning them from outside. You understand? So I do think that is one way of us embracing it. But also at the different health facilities, young people still report of unfriendliness of these services. They go to health facilities and some of them are chased away. You are still young. Some of them are, you know, but when they're actually involved in these relationships, because you chasing that young person doesn't mean that you're going to follow them up to see what they are doing. So I think even at the health facilities and different places, they need to embrace the fact that young people are engaged in these relationships. The information is so available everywhere. So they need to support young people and equip them to be able to, you know, make decisions. I believe that there is no young person who wants to be a teen mother, but they need that support from everywhere for them to be able to make that decision about their lives, to live a healthy life, so that the girls become mothers when they are ready. But because of that lack of support, they end up being part of these statistics.
Well, you do mention of some of the gaps that we currently see in the adoption of contraceptives, but there are also some notions or myths around the use of contraceptions, in terms of when you use contraceptions when you're still young, it's likely to affect your fertility in the near future. Could you speak to us in regards to that?
I think there are a lot of myths and misconceptions about contraceptives. That is true. One thing I can say is that for the teenagers who are using them, including their parents, the best thing is for you to get the information from the right places. We have leading service providers of contraceptives like Mary Stops Uganda, UNFPA, and Reproductive Health Uganda, and many others. Try to look out to their sources of information and also contact to get the right information, because you know, like, myths just move around people, and then if you do not have the right information, then you're going to follow that myth. But I do believe that these service providers alongside the government have provided enough information for every method or every contraceptive that is being used, and it is available for them to access so that they are aware before they make any decision on using them.
Well, as we conclude our conversation this evening, World Contraception Day is long gone, and it really wanted to address the fact that every single child that is brought into this world should really be wanted by the parents. What are some of those things that as we move on, as we carry on, we should continue to reflect on?
First of all, you see, last year when we went into the pandemic, the lockdown and everything, Makere School of Public Health and Gutmark Institute carried out a research on utilization of contraceptives, and they realized that the first 2 months the access in terms of numbers went down, but of course that is due to the factors of transportation and what. But then after that, for the rest of the year, the demand and utilization was high. That means that the demand for contraceptive is high among young people. Even before you talk about services, but the demand is high, it means young people are looking for contraceptives. Why are they looking for them? So because they need them, depending, basing on different factors, the relationship they have and things like that. So I think I would issue a call to action for every stakeholder, and that includes not just the government, but partners, including the parents and the different gatekeepers, to understand that it's a responsibility for all of us to ensure that young people are supported in terms of information, in terms of access, so that they are able to make the right decisions about their sexual and productive health. And when we do that, we are giving them a chance to live healthy lives, and in that regard, we are also contribute the well-being of the country.
All right, thank you so much, JOHNSON KIIZA of Public Health Ambassadors of Uganda, joining us tonight to speak about the latest statistics that we have in contraception adoption among the teenagers in the country. You too can send us your thoughts on our social media platforms, NTV Uganda on Facebook and NTV Uganda on Twitter. We'll take a short break, and NTV Weekend Edition, we return shortly.